Hello, dear fans, friends, and subscribers. Welcome to the Cricket Happening Show as usual. And on this particular Cricket Happening Show, we are going to look at three matches. One is going to be two matches which are played. One is New Zealand have very quickly wrapped up the series against Zimbabwe, two test series, and New Zealand quickly wrapped it up. In fact, they went down to a big win, and Zimbabwe could not put the same amount of effort as they put in the first innings, as they meekly succumbed to being 132 all out, basically making it a no contest, with New Zealand actually being the victors, and the test series was done and dusted, with New Zealand actually winning the two match series 2-0, and that I'll be talking about. And as far as West Indies and India were concerned, well, India, Ravichandran Ashwin went on. In fact, a morning session, the West Indies had to return wicketless, which was a good thing, which was done by Ashwin and Saha, who actually put up a very good partnership. In fact, they have put a 213 runs partnership in the morning, with Ashwin actually getting on to his fourth test century. And let me tell you, all his four centuries have come against the West Indies. So he really loves the West Indies there, Ravichandran Ashwin. And Riddhiman Saha also went on to pick up his maiden century with some very, very defiant batting from Riddhiman Saha as he contributed. He got his maiden test century. And that is good news for India, because Riddhiman Saha has taken the place of Mahendra Singh Dhoni, who was retired. And I thought he has done a great job here. And that enabled the Indians to be 353 all out. And at stumps on day two, the West Indians had put up a solid reply. They were 107 for one. And also tomorrow, it's the beginning of the final test match, which is going to be starting in the Ashes series. Not in the Ashes series, I'm extremely sorry. In the series between test series between England and Pakistan, England are 2-1 up right now, and now it is going to be the fourth and final test match, which is coming up tomorrow, and that is going to be something that Pakistan would be hoping that they would have a chance to level the series, and this is going to be played at the Oval, which I will be. Subject to time, I will definitely have a look at that as well. So now I will be starting off with the New Zealand versus Zimbabwe game. As far as New Zealand versus Zimbabwe were concerned, yesterday, as I said, after Zimbabwe put up a very good show in the first innings, one was probably expecting, but again, it was too much to expect, I would say, because especially considering that the final day pitch, it's always going to be difficult on a final day pitch. And well, today Zimbabwe were really no match to the New Zealanders, as wickets kept on falling. It was Martin Guptill, very unusually, was given the ball, and Martin Guptill definitely had his with his spin actually picked up three wickets. In fact, he picked up Craig Irvine, the century maker for 27 with four boundaries, and unfortunately there was not much of a resistance at all from Zimbabwe. It was Mavoyo out for 35 with 5 boundaries, and then we saw Trepano, the night watchman, who resisted for quite some time, 22 with 3 boundaries. Craig Irvine could not carry his form further, as he was out for 27 with 4 fours. Masuarek struggled at 11 with 1 boundary. Sean Williams could contribute only cheap. He was dismissed cheaply for 11 with 2 boundaries, and then the tail was wiped out by Sodhi and Guptill. With Guptill, as I said, in fact, the Zimbabweans were all out for 132. And Martin Guptill had very impressive figures of 7 overs, 4 minutes, 7 runs and 3 wickets. And Ish Sodhi also had some impressive figures, 11.4 overs, 5 maidens, 19 runs and 3 wickets. And these three really were the one who actually shared the spoils today, as the Zimbabweans were all out for 132. Thus, New Zealand registering a 254 runs victory, and thus taking the two-match test series 2-0. Kane Williamson, the New Zealand captain, was the player of the match, and the player of the series going to Neil Wagner of New Zealand, who really showed some real fury in his bowling, I would say, And he was also very, very successful with his bowling, as you know. And we know Neil Wagner is a very, very aggressive type of bowler. And definitely, that is something that cricket definitely needs, because the pace bowlers being aggressive is something that one is really looking forward to. And Neil Wagner is such a type of person who brings a lot of aggression into his bowling and also into his body language. Well, so from here, we will go to the West Indies. And as I said, today Ravichandran Ashwin and Riddhiman Shah resumed their batting on the opening day. And one has to really credit them. As I said, the second new ball was just 9 overs old yesterday, and there was definitely some juice in the pitch. And also, a new ball in the morning, definitely there would be a lot of movement. So one has to really, really commend both Ravichandran Ashwin, who was actually playing very well, but Riddhiman Shah was just blocking it out in the center and was really, really wearing off that second new ball. So both Ashwin and Shah did a good job of really seeing off the opening spell from Shannon Gabriel, Alzari Joseph and Cummins. And also, as I said, Riddhiman Shah was very, very defiant. He just kept on blocking around. There were a lot of balls which were hurled at them, which were made to fend. But definitely, it was a brave resistance by both Ashwin and Shah in particular, I would say. Ashwin was the one who was really making the scoreboard move. As both started carrying forward the good work that they did yesterday. And in fact, at lunchtime, both were unseparated, and the frustration was beginning to boil over for the West Indians, as in the morning session before lunch, the West Indies could not pick up a single wicket. And Ravichandran Ashwin went on to register his 4th test century. As I said, he has a big liking for the West Indian bowling, and Ravichandran Ashwin has already has got 4 centuries in his test career, and all the 4 centuries have come against the West Indies. And Riddhiman Shah, he went on to get his maiden test done, and what a feeling it would be. And also, it is good news for India too, because after Mahendra Singh Dhoni, the wicketkeeper, the successful captain and wicketkeeper batsman has retired, Riddhiman Shah is the one who's filling in the shoes. And it will be a refreshing thing to note that Riddhiman Shah went on to make a maiden test done. And also it shows he came in a real crisis time for India, and what a partnership. In fact, it was a very big partnership. The 200, they came together at 126 for 5 and their Indian chips were down. And look at what they did. They absolutely transformed the situation with a 213 runs, beautiful partnership, where they weathered the West Indian pace bowlers in a very, very bold manner and a brave manner. And here the results were all to see. So I think this was the only, the as far as the Indian batting was concerned, so 213 runs. But after lunch, everything went awry for India. I mean, they were 339 for 6. And in a matter of just 14 runs, the whole team folded for 353, as it all started with Shah being dismissed first by Alzari Joseph, who picks up his 3rd wicket to get Shah for 104 with 13 boundaries. And there was a spell where Shah slowly, he was pretty slow as far as his batting was concerned. But suddenly we saw a flurry of boundaries coming from Shah's bat in one particular over. And things were really, really going on. But after that, as I said, the Indians totally succumbed. Once Shah was gone, it was the turn for Jadeja to succumb to the bowling of Cummins for 6 with 1 boundary. And then there was some short stuff coming in with Bhuvneshwar Kumar at the crease. Gabriel and Cummins were bowling some throat pitch balls, one could say, as Kumar fended off the bowling of Gabriel for naught. And there was real raw pace coming in there. And then Ashwin also succumbed after making 118 with 6 fours and 1 6. And Ishan Sharma also fended off the bowling of Miguel Cummins. And Miguel Cummins was wicketless. I mean, he has not even got any single test wicket in his career. And now he did a good job by capturing 3 wickets for 54 runs. It would be a big relief for Miguel Cummins that finally has opened his account in test cricket as far as wickets are concerned. Mohammad Shami was left not out on not. 353 all out, thanks to Ashwin and Saha. And the bowling, the wickets, Gabriel, 2 wickets for 84, 3 for 69 for Alzari. Joseph had a very good debut, 3 for 54 for Miguel Cummins. So finally, I would say, really got off the blocks as far as wickets, test wickets are concerned. And 2 for 70 for Austin Chase. Now, 353 all out. Now, it was the turn for the West Indians to get onto this pitch. It was interesting to see as to what they will do. But Leon Johnson and Brathwaite definitely played very well. I mean, I wouldn't say that the Indians were able to really generate that extra pace and bounce that the West Indians were able to. So it will be very interesting to see what happens tomorrow in the morning. That would be crucial to me because this was probably after tea West Indies. This was second. There was it was a new ball, no doubt about it. But I thought Brathwaite was definitely, leaving the balls harmlessly outside the off stump, and also he was also always he was waiting for the loose ball to take opportunity off. Leon Johnson also was nicely blocking, and both did a fine job of actually putting on an opening partnership of 59 runs for the first wicket. And the Indian bowlers couldn't get. There were some edges which were going, but it was not going to hand. And I would say Brathwaite and Johnson did a fine job of putting on 59 for the first wicket. As I said, the Indian bowlers could not generate the same, but one is waiting to see as to. But the ball is pretty old right now, it's 47 overs old. So tomorrow in the morning, one couldn't probably make a judgment, but definitely they will get some with the old ball. It's going to be there, it will be interesting to see as to what they do. But again, as I said, this particular ball is 47 overs old, so one can't expect much. And Brathwaite and Johnson are going on well, and only it took the brilliance of KL Rahul to really spot a sort of a loophole, and he ran out Leon Johnson for 23 with two boundaries. So that was the only wicket that fell, and after that Darren Bravo walked in. And India definitely put Virat Kohli definitely started putting some pressure on Bravo by having the slips in place. But one can definitely say that Darren Bravo looked more confident than before for the first time in this test series, as he was very sure where his off stump was, and he played with authority. And at the other end, as I said, Brathwaite was one who was just chiseling together an innings, as both saw of the West Indies at stumps at 107 for 1, with Darren Bravo not out on 18 with two boundaries, and Brathwaite has already reached his 50. He was not out on 53 with six boundaries. So West Indies definitely doing a good job, I would say, of putting up a solid reply of 107 for 1 in reply to India's 353 all out. And as I said, it's all a matter of application. Ridhiman Saha and Ashwin showed it. And it's also good news for the West Indies that Bravo is looking good. Bravo is not making the same mistakes, and I hope he does not make the mistake that he did in the test series of fishing outside the off stump. But Bhuvneshwar Kumar bowled well, 11 for 11 runs. Mohammad Shami, 9 overs, 1 mid, and none for 35. I'm not going to go into the bowling figures here. That is as far as this match is concerned. Tomorrow, as I said, England and Pakistan are renewing their rivalry in the fourth test match, and Pakistan would be are the ones who would be under pressure. For England, if they win it, they take the series. Already they have already taken the series. Pakistan, even if Pakistan win, the only thing that they can do is they can level the series. So, but looking at the teams here for England, well, there can't be much changes. It should be the same. But also one thing that one could note here is that Chris Wokes is on to a record. As I said, 23 wickets is the record which is held by James Anderson. And if Chris Wokes takes one more wicket, I think he would have set a new record for England-Pakistan wickets in a series, I reckon. And Pakistan, now as far as Pakistan are concerned, the news that is coming in from Mickey Arthur, the coach, is that Mohammad Hafiz would probably make way for Iftikhar Ahmed. So Iftikhar Ahmed is one who's off spinner, and he's also a useful bat. So one would probably see Sami Aslam opening with Azhar Ali, and Mohammad Hafiz might get the boot tomorrow. And then Yunis Khan is another one on whom the eyes are going to be trained, because he has been struggling in this series. As I said, Yunis Khan and Misbahul Haq are the kingpins of Pakistan with their experience in batting. But Yunis Khan is struggling. Mohammad Hafeez has been struggling. And that has been the problem area for Pakistan. So Yunis Khan, whether he can get over it tomorrow. Misbahul Haq, always a great contributor to Pakistan cricket. Asad Shafiq, well, he definitely didn't do well in the last test match, as we all know. He collected a pair. But I'm sure he's much more talented than what it is turning out to be. And I'm sure he's going to get some runs under his belt tomorrow. Sarfaraz Ahmed has also not really, he has not shown his consistency here. He has shown it in patches, and that's not it. You need it in a consistent form. And the bowling, well, it is going to be in the hands of Mohammad Ami, Sohail Khan, Rahat Ali, who did a fine job in the previous test too, and Yasir Shah, as usual, spinning away for them. Well, and as far as this particular pitch is concerned at the Oval, one is told that definitely there is a green tinge on the pitch, so it will definitely keep the Pacers interested, no doubt about it. But also, one thing that one has to note is that when the last match was played in the English domestic scene, one saw that the spinners Gareth Batty and Zafar Ansari had a real field day. So probably it will also help the spinners in the final stages. So it'll be interesting to see what the captains do after winning the toss. In my opinion, considering this fact, I'm sure if Alistair Cook, the English captain, wins the toss, I'm pretty sure that he's going to insert England, insert Pakistan into bat, because he doesn't want to bat last on this pitch against Yasir Shah. Well, dear fans and subscribers, that really sums up this cricket happening show of mine today. Hope you all loved it, and there's more to come tomorrow. Till such time, I see you folks. It's goodbye. Thank you.